Welcome to Unity Real-Time Light Training Part 2. This is a list of topics covered in this video. We'll begin with lab setup. Each lab is assigned a primary lab number by Bio-Rad. Additional lab numbers for like instruments are available upon request. To set up a lab, click the Lab button. Type the lab number provided by Bio-Rad, as well as the required information. Finally, click Add. Now that we've set up one lab, continue setting up other lab numbers if necessary. Next, let's look at the setup of lots. There are two ways to manually set up a lot: adding and duplicating. Adding should be used for totally new control products. Duplication is helpful when switching to a new lot number of an existing control. Duplication copies test settings and rule selections to the new lot. To add a lot, select the lab number that the lot will be added to. Click the Lot button. Then select the control. Non-Bio-Rad controls may be set up. Please refer to the user guide for details. Select the lot. Click Add. The lot is added. Now let's take a look at duplicating a lot. Select the lab number that the lot will be duplicated to. Click the Lot button. Select the lot number you want to duplicate. Click Duplicate. Select the new lot number. Select the checkbox for each lab you want the lot duplicated to. You have the ability to duplicate each item listed here. We recommend pausing the video to review this note on best practices. Click OK. The new lot number appears. To close a lot when you're done using it, select the lot, then click Close Lot. We recommend closing the old lot rather than deleting it. To reopen a lot, select the lot and click Open Lot. Next, let's look at the setup of tests. There are multiple ways to set up new tests. Some customers add a single test manually. Others add multiple tests using the instrument setup feature. And some are required to add tests using their connectivity solution. We'll focus on the first two. Select the lab and lot you want to add the test to. Click the Test button. The Test dialog box opens. This is where you can select the test and its attributes. Select a test here. To make finding tests easy, you can search and filter the lists. You also need to select an instrument and reagent. Vitro's customers will also need to specify the slide generation number for the dry slide instruments. Please refer to the user guide. Then select a method and unit. You may set up tests that are qualitative or semi-quantitative if the test exists in the database. Contact Bio-Rad if your test is not listed. Finally, select a temperature. Click Add. The new test appears in the Open Tests list. In some cases, instrument setup is the preferred method because it's faster. It allows you to add multiple tests at the same time. From the Test dialog box, click Instrument Setup. Next, the Instrument Setup dialog box appears. Select an instrument. If your instrument is not listed, please contact Bio-Rad, but you can use manual setup to proceed. Verify the unit selection is correct. All tests for the instrument are selected by default. It's possible that two equally valid versions of the test appear. Clear the checkbox for the tests that you do not want to add. Click OK. The new tests appear in the Open Tests list. Review each test to ensure that it's configured correctly. Please note that if you're a customer setting up a Vitro's instrument, in addition to clearing the checkbox for tests you don't run, you'll also enter the slide generation number. Let's return to the Test dialog box. Some customers may find it helpful to arrange tests in a particular order. Use the drag-and-drop method to move a single test. Next, let's look at the setup of a user. Unity Real-Time Lite provides profiles with passwords and permissions to control user access to program functions. To set up a new user, select Tools, Security, Administrator. The Administrator dialog box appears. Click New. Enter the user ID, username, password, and initials. Clicking this checkbox gives the user all permissions. These are the permissions. Refer to the user guide for more details. Click Apply. Finish by assigning lab numbers to the user. This allows the user to view QC data in the software. Click the Assign Lab Numbers button. The Assign Lab Numbers dialog box appears. Use the drop-down menu to select the user you're setting up. Select one or more lab numbers to assign to the user. QC data is visible to the user based on these selections. Click OK. The user is now set up. Next, we recommend that you verify the settings in the Setup dialog box. This allows you to take full advantage of the software's capabilities. Select Tools and Setup. The Setup dialog box allows you to customize the software, including automated notifications. At a minimum, we recommend you activate these features to ensure your software is up to date. You can use Unity Real-Time Lite to evaluate your data by setting up rules. Rules can be set up at the lot or test level. Best practice recommends setting up rules at the test level. However, the most efficient way to set up rules is by lot, where you set up general rules for the entire lot of tests. Then identify tests with rules that are slightly different and edit the rules at the test level. Select a lot, then click the SPC Rules button. The Lot Settings dialog box appears. Let's take a look at the various parts of this screen. The Rule buttons allow you to see a description of the rule. Click a Rule button to view an explanation. Some rules have two applications, with in and across runs. Both will be applied in the software, but you can select them separately to see the explanation. In this section, you can select the status for each rule. This includes reject, warn, or off. The default setting is off. Points that are rejected are not submitted to the peer group. Points that are flagged with a warning are submitted. Let's set up one rule to warn and one to reject. To apply the rules to all lab numbers that use this lot, select the checkbox. Click OK. A message about best practice appears. Select Yes or No. In this case, we'll click Yes. Remember, you can edit individual tests within the lot as necessary. Select the test in the navigation tree. Click the SPC Rules button. Notice the rules that are already in use. Edit the rule selection for the test. Click OK. Now this test's rules have been edited, but the rules for the other tests within the lot remain the same. Continue your training by viewing Part 3.